Alright guys, well I'm back on the trailer again. The weather really turned here. It got really cold down into the 30s, so haven't had a really opportunity to get out here and start painting since it's been so cold. But today, the sun's out and I've got some lights on in the garage here and got the garage up to about 65 degrees, maybe even closer to 70, which is good. Good enough to paint. So as you can see, I have the paint here. This is what I'm going to be using. It's called Rust Bullet. We'll see just how this stuff works. It's supposed to be one of the best rust covers, inhibitors, whatever you want to call it. It seals in the rust and it stops it from rusting. So we're just going to paint the entire trailer with this twice, and hopefully that will protect it from rusting again for quite a long time. So I'm going to get the painting here. One thing they did say is that it's very toxic, so I'm going to have the garage open just a little bit to get some air through here. And it also, if you get it on your hands, it does not come off without actually wearing off. It takes a week or so to wear it off. So I have some gloves I'm going to be wearing, as you can see there. And also it says once you've opened the can, you have to finish within 2 days, 2 to 3 days, because the stuff will go bad on you. So we're going to get this going. Hopefully I'll get this thing painted at least one coat today, or at least most of it. We'll see how that goes, and finish up maybe tomorrow. But I definitely want to hit everything underneath and everywhere that needs it. So, all right, I'm going to get the camera set up here, and we're going to get moving. I'm going to start with the front here and work my way back. Stuff is really, really thin, so I'm going to have to be careful I don't get any drips. So, all right, but it's looking pretty good. Definitely looking a lot better. All right, first coat is done. Looks really good. Nice shiny gloss black. You can see over here, it's like a mirror. Really came out nice. Not bad for brushing it on with a brush and not even spraying it. So definitely looks really nice. Everything came out good. Gonna do the second coat. In a day or so, I'm gonna let this one dry, and then do the second coat. Gotta do the inner fender wells yet, so I gotta pull these tires off and get them out of the way, and do the suspension parts too. So with the second application, I shouldn't need as much paint. I used the whole pint on this one, completely gone, so that was good. That was just enough. I calculated that it would be just enough, and fortunately it worked out that way. Doesn't always, but anyways, it's really looking good. I like this black color. It's just it's going to make this thing look really nice, especially once I get the wood back on it for the deck. So, but really, I'm happy with the way it's turned out. That paint is really something else. It just soaks right into the metal, especially where it has rust. It just sucks right into it and binds it together. So it doesn't really like to adhere to anything that's painted already. It doesn't stick real well to that. So there's a couple spots that I had like that. So I went over it a couple times to find it stick, but it took a lot longer to get it stuck. So anyways, you can see that these beams look really good. They soak that paint right up. So second application should really look good. I'm really, really impressed with these fenders here. Look at that. It like a mirror finish. Pretty awesome. I'm sure that'll get scratched up right away once you start using it, but it looks cool now. All right, guys. Well, that's an update for here here at the garage, and hopefully we'll have some more updates here real soon. So, thanks for watching.